Hi all.
What the topic I'm going to discuss is Raman effect. We all Indians know Sir C.V. Raman quite well. He's the first Indian to get Indian scientist to get a Nobel Prize. Also, he's the first non-white man to get recognized by a Nobel Prize in any branch of science. And our government of India has honored him with a stamp which shows the effect. So this is a spectrum which I will be discussing in detail in the coming slides. This is basically the Raman effect. When light of certain wavelength falls on material, the vibrational modes of certain molecules, as seen in this picture, is interacting with the light and it gives some amount of energy to the incoming radiation, and thereby the outgoing radiation from the material will have either higher energy or lower energy. The higher energy radiation which is coming from the sample is anti-Stokes Raman, which is having a shorter wavelength, right? And the higher wavelength radiation which is coming from the sample, or the lower energy radiation, that is called Stokes line. Whereas the line which is having the same energy as the incident radiation is called Rayleigh scattering. But what is important for us is most of the time this Stokes Raman shift. So when you take a Raman spectrum of a material, what if you plot intensity versus lambda, then you will have a curve like this. At lambda 0, you will get a peak, and at a higher energy, you will get the anti-Stokes line. Whereas at equal separation from the line at a lower energy, you will get another peak which is called Stokes line. Stokes. Whereas this axis is intensity of light which is coming out from the sample. But this energy difference between the Rayleigh line or the Stokes line or anti-Stokes line, they are equally separated from the Rayleigh line, and this separation is a signature of this molecule or the vibrational mode of this molecule. So how much ever is the energy of this vibrational mode, that is what is reflected as a peak on either side. Generally, since anti-Stokes line involves giving energy to the radiation by the vibrational mode, that is less probable in nature. So this taking energy from the radiation by the vibrational mode is most probable, and hence we look mostly at this region called Stokes Raman line. Okay, so this is basically about the phenomena of Raman effect. So what it is used for? Basically, it is used for characterizing material. It's one of the best methods to characterize materials in order to check the purity of materials. Also, one can study electronic properties of materials. For example, diamond is one of the best examples. We think diamond is the best or the purest material that we can get. So we give to our relatives or close ones. And diamond is having certain vibrational features. So that is only specific for diamond. It cannot be for any other material. So most of us would have studied the structure of diamond, like carbon atoms are bonded in a tetrahedral fashion like this. And then all of these angles are same. So it will having a strong 3D structure. So, but the relative change of atoms between these corners of the diamond, that relative motion is having a particular frequency or energy. So that will come in 1300 and so centimeter inverse energy range. That is unique for diamond. So that comes up as a peak in the Raman spectrum. Even if the diamond doesn't look like a diamond and it is showing this feature, it is certainly a diamond. And even if the material is looking exactly like diamond, but it doesn't have such a peak in Raman spectrum, it is not diamond, because you cannot cheat nature, because the vibrational property of that material is unique and human can never interfere with that kind of a vibrational frequency, because it's much faster than our reach, and it is it's something which we cannot manipulate. So it is one of the best method to characterize or identify materials. So then we just look at the classical theory of Raman scattering. So the molecules which show a change in the polarizability is mostly Raman effect, Raman active. So polarizability, or the ability to get polarized, is represented by alpha, and that alpha is equal to alpha naught plus alpha prime into cosine of vibrational mode frequency into t. It is a cosine function of the vibrational mode, whereas this alpha naught is its natural polarizability when there is no vibrational excitation, when the molecule is sitting exactly like the average position, the ability to get polarized is this quantity, whereas this is corresponding to the particular vibrational mode of that particular material. But we know that the expression for a radiation is E is equal to E0 cos omega t. But this omega is different from this omega. This omega is for the is a frequency of the vibrational mode, whereas this is for the frequency of light, or the laser which is falling in. Okay, so then the induced dipole moment mu is equal to alpha into E. So you just multiply these two terms to get the induced dipole moment on the material. So what you'll be having is a term which is like this. You multiply both of these terms, then you multiply this term with the first term, so you get alpha naught E0 cos omega t, that is one term, plus you have alpha prime E0 and cos omega t, that is cos omega is the frequency of the radiation, into cos of omega vibrational into t. So you have cos a form which looks like cos a cos b. And when you think about such a term, so this first term has the same frequency as the incident radiation. So this is that term, which is alpha naught E0 cos omega t. So that is this term, the Rayleigh scattered line, whereas this line can be rearranged like cos A cos B. Cos A cos B is half cos of A plus B plus cos of A minus B. Okay, so when you do that, so you will have two terms which are also cosine functions with the frequency differences, one with the frequency differences and the one with the frequency added up. So you get one term, this blue one with omega plus omega vibrational, whereas the other term with this for the Stokes shift, you get omega minus omega vibrational. Okay, so those are cosine terms. Those are radiational frequencies which are separated equally by the amount of energy of the vibrational mode. Okay, so this is basically classical expression for Raman shift, whereas this picture shows you the quantum picture of Raman effect. So here, when the light, these four levels are different vibrational levels of the ground electronic state of the material. When laser falls on it, intense laser or light falls on it, the electron jumps to a virtual state and then it comes back to the original state. And if it comes back to the original state, it will be emitting a radiation which is of the same energy as the incoming radiation. So that is called Rayleigh line. Whereas if the material was already in one of the vibrationally excited state, then when it is hit by a radiation, it moves up by an amount of the photon energy. So then it moves to another virtual level which is higher. Then if it is coming back to the ground vibrational state of the ground electronic state, then you can see from the length of this arrow itself, this will be having a higher energy, or it will be blue shifted. So this line is called anti-Stokes line, whereas if it's coming to a higher ground vibrational state, so then from the length of the arrow itself, we can see that it will be having a lower energy or higher wavelength. So that's why we give this color red. So it's basically a quantum phenomena. So this is the quantum mechanical picture of Raman effect. So it's one of the best method to characterize material. It's a very interesting phenomena by which we can check the purity of the material, and it is so powerful that no one can cheat us in buying a diamond. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you all for listening. Have a good day.